Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you like the content, please like, share and subscribe to the channel. So let's go ahead and see what are the important short cards, SQL short cards we have as part of this video. First one, the requirement is like, while copying from input to output file using sort, I want to handle the below condition. In my input file, order number is of length 5 and I want to include the order numbers with only 00001 and 00002. Order number starts from position 200 in the input file and I want to write the order number in the first position in my output file, which is in the 200 position in the input file. Let's see the solution. As usual, we code outfill fnames is equal to sort out. Then while including, we'll be including only characters from 200 to length 5, starting from 200 length of 5, character equal to 00001 and same 2. Only these two should be included for the output. And in the outrec, we'll be formatting the outrec or output like, for the first position, we are getting the data from 200 position from the input file, which is of length 5, that is order number. And after 6th, from the 6th position in the output file, we are just copying the remaining data from input file. Let's see the second question. While copying the input to output using sort card, I want to write a simple header and trailer as below. The requirement is like in the first line, from 20th position, header should start and it should say daily orders report. In the second line, report generated on, it should give the date and page number at the 70th position. In the second line only, at 70th position, we should give the page number. And in the third line, we should give a time and you should mention the time. The time should be just below the date. In the second line, that is about the header. In the trailer, it should give total records, it should give the number of records, and in the next line and in the middle of the report, it should say end of report. Yeah, let's see the solution for this. So header, it will say in the mid or 20th position, you can change the position according to the requirement. It will say daily orders report. This shows the next line. And in the next line from first position itself, it says report generated on and it will give you the date in MD4 format. The date will be separate, date, month and year will be separated by slash. And in 70th position, it says page and ampersand page will give you the page number. This again shows the next line. And in the third line, I'm just giving some blank spaces because they have mentioned the time has to come exactly below the date. So in exactly below the date, I'm coding the time and this will be having the slash. And in trailer, as they said, it should start from the first position and say total records and it should give the count. This count keyword will give you the count of records in the input file. And this give this take you to the next line. And from 34th position, maybe that is the middle of the report, it says end of report. So this is the solution for that requirement. Third question is, explain the below outrec sort card. In the outrec, we do a lot of reformatting, especially the numeric fields and all. Let's see what is it. 29, 9, 129, 2, 61, 1, then 88, 8, which is a PD, fact decimal, edit into some format. Let's see what it says. So there 29, 9 it will puts input position from starting from 29 and the length 7, so 29 to 37 in the output position from 1 to 9. Then 129 comma 2 puts input position 129 and 130, the length is 2, so to the output position. After this 1 to 9 we have copied from 10 and 11, it will copy from 129 to 2. So from 12th position it starts from 61 to 1. If you see, if you remember that in the question, this puts in input position 61 and length, that is only 1, that is 61, in the position output position 12. And the next one, 88 to 8, PD edit, this actually converts the 8 byte, which is mentioned 88,8 PD value in position starting from 88 and with the length of 8, that is up to 95, 88 to 95, to a 15 digit, if you count it as 15 digit value with leading zeros. If it is the format is like this, it will automatically convert the value into leading zeros. If there are any zeros, or if there is only this much data being passed, it will append zeros there in the output position. Till here we have reformatted and put the data till 12th position. This starts from 13th position and it goes up to 15 digit, so it will go to 27. Let's see the next question. So while working with sort card, I want to build the output based on the input values. Okay, based on some condition, that means account type is of length 8 in my input file. Account type is one of the column and it is of length 8 that start from position 10, and another column which is minimum balance flag is 1 byte long and start from position 20. I have a requirement, like if account type is current, you need to set the minimum balance flag to star. For all other account types, you just need to copy the input records to output. I hope you understand the requirement. You can take some time and go through the question again, and let's see what is the solution for this. So option copy will copy the records from input to output as usual. In the outreg, we'll code if then when init, that is to copy without any conditions. If then when the actual requirement, when the account type is current, we need to populate in the 20th position, we need to copy star, that was the requirement. This will address that requirement. If then is equal to from starting from position 10 to 8 character equal to current, that means if it is current account, overlay for 20th position keep this value, that is star. If then when none, for other than this condition, build as usual. For the first position, you get the data from 1 to 80, or from beginning to end. Let's see the next question. What is the difference among build, find rep, and overlay? Actually, we use all these things with outreg. Let's see the difference among these three: build, find rep, find replace, and overlay. So coming to the first one, build, it reformats a record item by item. That means for each single item you should code, you should build the record from first position to the end of the file, record length, total record length. You must specify each item to be included in the output record. For an example, build, for first position you are getting this character account, and for the 11th position you are putting a space, 12th position you are getting some data from first to 200, like that. You should specify all items. But when it comes to find replace, it finds the text or constant specified in the entire input file. If you're passing some constant in the input, and in entire input file, it will finds and replaces it with the destination character with the out parameter. Let's see an example. outright find replace is equal to in, if in the input file if character data is found, change it to uppercase data. This is how it works. It actually finds the input character what you have mentioned and it replaces with this. Let's see the overlay. Overlay specific, like you only need to specify the items to be overlaid. Let's see an example. It was shown in the previous question also, like when this is the condition from starting from position 10 to the length of 8 character equal to current, then you will be overlaying the in the output file for the 20th position you are putting or populating star. So based on some condition you can just overlay a particular position in this one. Let's see the next question. What is the difference between inrec and outrec while using the sort? Many a times we use both. Let's see the difference. Inrec is processed before the records are sorted, merged or copied. Outrec is processed after the records are sorted, merged or copied. Like you know, where you are coding your sort, actual sort condition, that is differ. That is a one of the major difference when using inrec and outrec. And actually the condition is like the requirement, based on the requirement, if you are reformatting whatever you're doing, if it is going to decrease the size of records for output, then it is good to use inrec actually. And if your reformatting increases the size of records for your output, then it is good to use outrec. And if you are simply copying and using this inrec or outrec, it won't make any difference. If you are not reformatting, increasing and decreasing the size of output file, then both will act the same. Let's see the next question. I have a situation where the input file has details of customer number, address, amount paid and few more columns which are not needed for this. So I need to create two output files. First output file should have customer number, address and amount paid details. These are the three columns. And second output file should have only customer number and address. Amount should be made zeros. Okay, amount column also should be there in the output file, but it should made zeros. In a single sort card, how are we going to address it? Let's see. So out fill fnames is sort out. That is the first output file we are mentioning. For this first output file, all the three fields should be there. So I'm just populating in the outrec. First position, I'm going to take the customer number from first position to 10 length, and 11th position I'm going to take from 11 to 25 as usual. Suppose amount paid is populating at 50th position, so and in the input file amount is at 100th position, so I'm just copying 100th position to 8 length. That is for the first file. All three columns should be populated. For the second file, we have a requirement like we should make this amount paid is zeros. So all other two columns like customer number and address will be same. But for the amount paid column, I'm just making it zeros to address the requirement. 8x, that is of zero characters. Let's see the next question. I need to compare two reports for comparing IDs and generate an output with non-matching records. Okay, with only non-matching output file, only non-matching records should come to file, output file. ID start from position 4 and length of 8. This is to compare the position, whatever the key length and where it starts. This is the information. Let's see the solution. So of course we need to do a join key for file 1 and file 2. with the same key, starting from position 4 and length of 8, and I am sorting it in ascending order. Join unpaired only file 2. So the requirement is not matching with the file 2 only. Reformat files also, we are including file 2 from 1 to 11. So option copy. Out file fnames, no match. We need only one single file which is not which is having not matching records for file 2, and we are building for that particular no match file. So this is the important thing, like where we join we do join unpaired, we include only F2 because we are finding the non-matched records with F2. Let's see the next question. I have a situation where the input file has details of customer number, address, amount paid. I need to create an extra column in the output file with amount multiplied with 5 times. Output file should have customer number, address, amount paid, and new column. So I have 3 columns in my input file. The output column, output file should have 4 columns. The fourth column should be created like, okay, the amount paid should be multiplied with 5 times. Let's see the solution. A single outreq fields will do for this. Actually 1 to 45, it actually copies the record from 1 to 45 position as usual, and this 35 to the length of 10, it will multiply with whatever this plus 4 signifies, multiplies with 5 times. It will multiply and it will populate in the output file. So let's see. Copies the record from 1 to 45 as I said, position as usual, and multiplies the amount PD, which is from position 35 to length 10 for each record, and writes to output file. So the amount field will start from 35 and it is the length of 10, so it is packed decimal format. It will multiplies with 5 times and it will write into the output file. Let's see the last question. What is remove CC and no detail in sort cards? We usually see whenever we do compare and whenever we use variable file also, we use remove CC, and sometimes we see no detail in the sort cards. Let's see what is the difference. First, remove CC parameter is used to remove the ANSI carriage control characters in your output records. I'll tell you what are those ANSI carriage control characters. Remove CC tells DF sort to remove the carriage control character from the first byte of each record. Each record's first byte will be having control character, but we don't want that character to be considered for our processing. So as a result of this, actually this control character, the data start from starts in column 1 of the report rather than in column 2 actually. So the when we see the history of this, originally out file was used to create printable reports actually. So these kind of control characters were needed by then when we actually using it for printable reports, but more modern users often don't require this ASA carriage control characters. So coding this remove CC on the outfield statement suppresses this control characters. Of course, we don't want these control characters to be considered for the processing. So to suppress these things, we mentioned remove CC, that is remove carriage control characters. So when we see no detail, that tells sort to process the data records in the usual way, but not to write them to the report data set. Let's see like an example. If you want to only record count, if you want only record count to be printed or returned to the output file, but you have to process the input file as usual, right? In that case, you can just mention no detail. So in this case, you want only record count to be printed in the output, but you need to process the input file as usual to get the count. So in that case, in that kind of cases, requirements, you can code no detail. So processing will be same, but you need you will write only what is needed in your output file.
Thank you so much for watching this video. Have a great day.